Hello and welcome back. In several of our previous lectures, we have looked at various aspects of cloud computing. Those of you who are already exposed to different forms of distributed computing, they will recognize that cloud computing is nothing but the next evolutionary step from several of the existing initiatives that have been carried out in past several years. For example, utility computing, grid computing, etc. They have existed for past several years and there have been significant work done in those fields. And it is important to understand what are the key differences when it comes to, let's say, the grid computing and the cloud computing. So in this lecture, I'm going to go over some of these details which differentiate these two important computing models. So here are some of the key parameters that differ in cloud and the grid computing models. So we'll go over each of these one by one. So just at a high level, we have these six major parameters which differ in the two cases, which make an important difference. First one is application focus, and then you have management, that is management of the infrastructure, etc. Business models that are available in both the paradigms, and then the middleware and programming models that differ, and also the usage patterns for computing resources, and finally the interoperability. So let's look at the application focus. In cloud computing, the business applications that you build are typically web-based applications. We have seen mostly businesses are interested in building web applications or the functionality which is exposed over the internet, typically consumed by end users by using some sort of a thin client such as a browser, web browser, or some handheld devices. Whereas on the grid, the focus of applications that you build and deploy on a grid infrastructure is basically for the purpose of scientific and research projects, where you collaborate amongst different administrative units to do the larger computation by using the grid infrastructure. Now let's look at the management. In case of cloud computing, the cloud infrastructure is operated by using a centralized management model. That is, from the viewpoint of users, there is a single access point with which the users interact to obtain the services. We have looked at examples in different service models, such as infrastructure as a service or platform as a service, etc. The users who want to obtain the cloud services, they first have to register, let's say. And thereon, they interact with the obtained resource directly, whether they have obtained a virtual machine or their application on a platform as a service kind of a cloud. From then onwards, you have a single point of access. Whereas on a grid, you have a decentralized management of system, which spans across geographically distributed sites. And each site has its own independent administrative control on the resources. Whereas this is not the case for a cloud setup. A central control is there. For example, you look at Amazon Web Services. So there is a centralized control on the entire set of services that a vendor like Amazon is offering. Another important aspect is business models. In case of cloud, typically the costing model for the services that you obtain is pay per use, or as they say, pay as you go. Means that you do not incur much upfront costs. When you want to obtain the services, you are basically renting it like a utility and you pay for the resources that you have used, that you have actually used. And that is a fairly standard practice across the cloud providers. And it also offer, the clouds also offer very very crisply distinct service models. For example, software as a service, platform as a service, and infrastructure as a service. These are the variants that we have already seen. Whereas if you look at grid, there is no such fundamental business model. So mainly it is operated in a collaborative manner, where the entities who want to pool their resources into a grid, they come for the incentive of getting a larger infrastructure to work with. Another important aspect is the programming model and the middleware. We have seen that on cloud, you have several different frameworks to set up, let's say, infrastructure as a service. So you may use frameworks like OpenNebula, Eucalyptus, OpenStack, etc. However, there is no standard framework that exists in infrastructure as a service space. each one of these frameworks, even though they may have a similar architecture at the core, but in terms of the APIs that they expose to the end users for managing the infrastructure or the resources that they obtain, they differ widely. And furthermore, when you go to platform as a service, for example, again, you may have different platforms and each one offering a different set of APIs for the clients to develop their applications and manage the cloud related services and so on. That is, there is no standard across different types of clouds. And the programming model depends on the type of service in case of cloud. Whereas if you look at the grid, you still have here different middleware softwares available, for example, Glite and Unicore, etc. However, there is a de facto standard across various implementations of different grids, and that is using Globus middleware. And the programming model here is often batch processing and job scheduled, where a dedicated set of resources are available for a particular task which the user submits to the grid infrastructure. And you typically use message passing APIs to perform these kind of tasks. Yet another important aspect is resource usage patterns. In case of cloud, if you look at, the computing resources are virtualized and they form a homogeneous layer in any given cloud setup. For example, in case of infrastructure as a service cloud, when you want to set up an IaaS cloud, you will use some sort of a virtualization technology to abstract out all the underlying hardware and expose to the higher layer a uniform set of computing resources from which you can create different virtual machines of different sizes, and end users can be given those virtual machines to use. And all of this, as we just said, is operated under a central control of the cloud provider. Whereas if you look at grid, the computing resources are fairly heterogeneous in nature, and all the hardware and software, etc., that is used in a collaborative manner. And finally, interoperability is another important aspect. If you look at cloud, vendor lock-in and integration still remains an important issue in cloud. For example, if you build an application on a Google App Engine, which is a PaaS platform, that, let's say, will not work on a different PaaS provider. For example, VMware Cloud Foundry. You may not take your Google App Engine web application and simply put it on VMware Cloud Foundry's platform and expect it to work. That may not happen. So in that sense, there is no standard across the cloud providers dealing with a similar kind of stack. In this case, we were talking of Google App Engine geared towards web application development. So the APIs and tools and other technologies that Google App Engine is offering is different from several of the other PaaS platform vendors like Microsoft Azure or even VMware Foundry and so on. So in that sense, you don't have any interoperability or portability of your applications from one vendor to another. Whereas if you look at grid technology deals with this problem, and between providers, you will be able to make your applications work. So in that sense, the situation is slightly better in case of grid than in case of cloud as it exists today. So I hope that these points help clarify the important differences which exists between these two important computing platforms. And they will help you understand the cloud computing platforms slightly in a better way. That's pretty much it for this short lecture. Thank you.